80 degree water, you probably wouldn't freeze to death until the second day. The water will still freeze you to death by slowly lowering your body temperature to its temperature. Makes sense, right? Slowly sucks your heat out. You die pretty slowly in 80 degree water, but you'd still probably die of hypothermia first before any other thing. And when it gets dark at night, and especially when it's cloudy, it's so dark that it's literally just a ship in a black void. You can't see the water, you can only hear it. When it's cloudy, you can't see any light outside. The only thing is the lights from the ship. It's just like being on a spaceship. And then in the sweltering tropical sun, there's the "I just want to jump overboard, the water seems so nice right now" conversation. A lot of times people just like to discuss the logistics of survival. If I jump overboard, maybe it's such and such a chance that they'd find me. If not, I calculate that this is how long I'd survive. This is the most likely scenario for my death. Maybe what I would think about while I was out there. Everyone describes the urge to jump just to see what would happen. To see if you get rescued or not, and then, yes, what would it be like just to be swimming in the middle of the ocean? So we have to lower the instruments off, so a lot of times we're hanging right over the stern, lowering an instrument into the water. It's only 8 feet down, and it would just be so easy. It would just be so easy. Yeah, this urge is a very, very known thing. It sort of conflates with the stories you hear in the galley, at dinner from the crew, talking about what happens, talking about you go overboard, how much time they have to rescue you. Basically, the rules like you've got about 30 seconds of seeing, of being able to actually see somebody in the water. Or they're too far away to see.
Mm-hmm.